invitation. I'm disclosing a few slides, some very nice native Annonas of Brazil. If we consider all Annonas or all Annonaceae that we have in Brazil, I would be talking until tomorrow night. A lot of fruits, maybe more than 200 fruits. But I will focus on the main ones and the ones that I consider the best ones. So we have the introduced plants, introduced Annonas and Oimondia, but these I will not talk. I will show just one slide about the native plants, the introduced plants, and the other focus will be in the Annona plants. Maybe if I have time, a few to get your plants too. And here you can have a general view. Some Duguetia is becoming so popular that today it's possible to buy an iPhone case of Duguetia Margraviana and the internet. Funny, the fruit is there. Well, Annona are beautiful fruits, and in the 17th century, some specialized at that time publication start to make some drawings and to share information about sugar apple at the left, at the Flora sinensis. That seems to be soursop. And the Linnaeus classic work described also a few species of Annona. But we have also a few Brazilian native fruits and not native fruits that some introduced that were shown by this guy called Albert Eckhout. Albert Eckhout was a Netherlands guy, a Holland guy that came to Brazil during the expedition of the Count Maurício de Nassau. Maurício de Nassau invaded part of Brazil, stayed there for more than 30 years. And he bring not just the army, but he bring also scientists, astronomers, painters. And this guy studied with Rembrandt, and is a contemporaneous of Vermeer. So a very good quality fruit, with some introduced one as watermelons and orange, some native ones as pineapple, passion fruit, cashews, but here a little bit hidden, you have an Annona. Probably it seems to be Annona montana. So, about almost 400 years ago, we have a good description of the image of Annona montana that is native of that part of Brazil that was invaded by the Holland army. I'll show you later Annona montana. Annona montana is an excellent good stock, as fruit is not so good. As I told you, the quantity of Annonaceae are huge, more than 2,000 species. And we focus here the native ones, the green ones, Annona, Genus, Lugitia, Fusaria, Porcelia, that looks like Popó, not so good. There are some good ones in the American continent, the Acimina genus and the Saprantus genus. Saprantus is a genus from Mexico that looks a lot like Acimina, like the Popó, is a tropical Popó. But the main focus here will be the Annona, and if I have time, a few Duguitia. Just to show you to understand what is this so close relative genus to the Annona. The first way to characterize an Annona was the flowers. But you have a lot of different flowers. You have velvety, globose, flattened, narrow, pyramidal, and even the propeller shaped rollinia. But after about 10 years ago, Raymond Heiner, that is the botanist of the Vienna University, he showed that the DNA of any kind of these fruits were more than 99% similar. So he joined again, he merged again the genus Rolinia and the genus Raymondia into the Annonas genus. So flower is important, but nowadays with new tools like DNA analysis is the best way to identify similarity between species, among species. The whole Annona group, the whole Annona genus, has almost 200 species with some focus of biodiversity, mainly in Central America and South Mexico, Caribbean, in the Amazon also, and the west part of the Amazon, Peru, a lot of nice species in Peru too. And in Brazil, in the central part of Brazil, in an area called the Cerrado. Cerrado is a dry savanna. Most plants from there are very difficult to be grown outside their native range.
Question, the dots, does that represent
places
where they're
found? Or no, species? That's a question. Because you have the dots, including the Galapagos Island. So, trees that are growing there, okay. not the native site of each species. Okay? You have there, you have even in Florida, of course in Florida you have at least Annona glabra, but these are places where you can find some of the 191 Annonas. We analyzed the groups. This group of Annona called Atai, the narrow, long petal Annonas, is a famous group because of the sugar apple, Ilama, Poste, Cherimoya, Annona reticulata, all of them belongs to this group. But this group is specifically situated in Central America, Caribbean, and South Mexico. You cannot see any native Annona of this group in Brazil. On the other hand, the global plants like this one that is Annona nuricata, or the other one at the right, the flattened one that is Annona spinensis, it's possible to see in the south part of Central America, but distributed along the South American continent. Some of them has the Annona spinensis group, they are more situated at the central part of Brazil, and the global plants are more situated at the Amazon. That's important because I will mention later about pollination of Annona and the flower architecture. Has a strong influence in how to be pollinated. Some plants are not used to be pollinated naturally outside its native range because the bugs doesn't have the right tools to pollinate it. So we need to help them. And the last one, the old genus Rolinia that was merged with Annona. The flower looks a propeller, but even the propeller has some different shapes as the Rolinia mucosa or Rolinia deliciosa. The one at the right nowadays Annona leptopetale with red petals, and the strange one Annona neocerise. In the picture, the black dots means between 5 and 7 species. The white dots means just one species. So you can see that the main diversity place of the Rolinia is in southeast Brazil, near Rio de Janeiro, or in west part of South America, maybe near Peru. The white dots, a lot of white dots along the north of Amazon and Central America, are due just one species, the well-known Annona mucosa or the former Rolinia deliciosa. Well, let's talk about introduced plants. Annonas are so popular in Brazil that most people think that the Annonas famosa, the sugar apple, or Annonas unicata, they are native fruits. They are not native fruits. Annonas famosa is from Caribbean and Yucatan in Mexico. And Annonas unicata is in the Caribbean too. But look at of the diversity of Annonas famosa in the second picture in Mexico. They call their saramujo in Mexico. A lot of different colors, probably different tastes too. The same for Ilama. Fruits with pulp very white until pulp red vine in color. Ilama is not introduced well in Brazil. We have just a few